Hi everyone, thanks for stopping by, thanks for your time and thanks for leaving a comment. If you have not yet subscribed to this channel, consider it, then do it. Today I will spend a few minutes sharing on the topic, the water is cold, will my fish die? I have shared with you in several videos issues I have experienced regarding aquarium water temperature. Today this share emphasis is on temperature of the aquarium water. In Jamaica during the months of January through to August, recorded temperature when analyzed, was at its highest in almost two decades. Drought water restriction, rapid evaporation of pond moisture and dried up rivers occurred. Since the month of September 2019, there has been an increased level of rainfall. This has resulted in rivers becoming active again, water restrictions eased and my pond fish rest at the base of the pond at nights. Whenever a pond or aquarium gets too warm, you would see fish around the air filter, or beneath the space where the water from the filtration system hits the water in the aquarium. This may prove too much for large fish species which makes its home at the base of the aquarium or pond. In reality, warm water holds less oxygen than cold water. In the event of pond water becoming too warm, fish stock would probably die from low levels of oxygen before the increased temperature do affect their health. Your fish stock will do several things when it is comfortable. Some of these things include but not limited to, 1, decrease in aggression, 2, consume more food than usual depending on actual temperature and fish species. Some fish like the goldfish and koi may hibernate when it does get too cold. Some fish species will reproduce, example koi catfish, they do this during cooler temperature, while some will not. Another situation linked with aquarium water temperature is that, aquarium and ponds fish bio load may change depending on species and temperature. In some cases, some fish species tend to do more jumping during warmer months than during cooler months. In addition, some insects do not remain in water all year round. Some insects are no longer a threat. For some insects, the practice of hibernation ensures the survival of their species type. At times it may seem as if these insects to disappear, then return when the temperature is more favorable to them. A fish which eats a lot will have a higher volume of waste than those considered to be hibernating. You should never feed fish when it is too cold. This is in reference to fish which are designed to shut down when it gets too cold. Again, koi and goldfish are prime examples. You should be careful when designing your pond or aquarium setup. Whenever it gets too cold, your fish stock will go into shock and might die. My ponds suffer at both ends. Whenever it gets too cold or warm, the plants will die. As a result, constant replenishing of plant stocks are needed when ponds are designed to remain outdoor for the entire year. What has your experience been like? Do you use a fan or air conditioned system to maintain a steady temperature within your fish space? Or do you just open the windows when you are home and close them when you leave? Share your opinions on this and other matter mentioned throughout this presentation. One love, Raleigh.